Good morning, Saugus. I'm Lexi Reynolds, and today is Tuesday, February 15th. This is SNN. To celebrate Black History Month, we thought we'd introduce you to James Baldwin. James Arthur Baldwin was born to Emma Burtis Jones on August 2nd, 1924 in New York City. As the oldest child in his family, he worked part-time jobs to help support his family. Baldwin began writing in the mid-1940s, at first writing articles for articles and reviews for various newspapers before writing his first essays, The Harlem Ghetto and The New Leader. Baldwin often suffered prejudice over his race and sexual orientation, which led him moving to Paris in 1948. While in France, he wrote some of his best works, such as Go Tell It on the Mountain, Givoni's Room, and The Discovery of What It Means to Be an American. In his writings, he explored the many racial and sexual prejudices that pervaded the U.S. Through his writing, he also fought for civil rights for both African Americans and members of the LGBTQ community. Despite suffering hostile treatment over his sexuality from both civil rights activists and those that opposed civil rights, he made significant contributions that laid the groundwork for a greater fight for true equality. Please stand for the flag salute.
Please stand. Put your right hand over your heart. Ready, begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may now be seated.
Congratulations to Levin Lamb, who has been chosen by the American Legion to represent Saugus High School at Boys State. Levin will be spending a week this summer in Sacramento attending California Boys State, where he will be participating in a simulation government program with boys from all throughout the state. Congratulations again. Another congratulations to Future Business Leaders for America for their success at sectionals. Caitlin Park came in first place for advertising. Calvin Zwicker came in second place for accounting. Alex Beck came in fourth place for intro to FBLA. Isabella Arabian came in fifth place for marketing. And Jeremy De Leon came in sixth place for business law. Congratulations again. Now let's go to girl boss Marie Morcos with today's Saugus sports update.
Thank you, Lexi. Good morning, Saugus. I'm Marie Morcos with today's Saugus Sports Update. Today, boys soccer plays Beaumont High at Beaumont. Varsity plays at 5. Also today, boys basketball plays Cajon at Saugus. Varsity plays at 7. Boys tennis plays Crespi at Saugus. Varsity plays at 3. Boys baseball plays Oaks Christian at Oaks Christian. JV and varsity games start at 3. Girls lacrosse has a game against Louisville at Crespi. Varsity plays at 6:30. It's our first game of the season. Let's win this, girls. Tomorrow, boys tennis plays against Buckley. Varsity plays at Saugus at 3. JV plays Balboa Tennis Center at 3:15. Also tomorrow, boys baseball plays Camarillo at Camarillo. Frosch plays at 3. Boys lacrosse plays Hart at Hart. Varsity plays at 3:30, and JV plays at 5. Good luck, Matt Hollenbaugh. Good luck to all of our Centurion athletes. The intramural 3-on-3 March Madness basketball tournament is here. Sign-up sheets are available in the ASB office. All teams must consist of at least 3 players and have an appropriate team name. Games last 20 minutes and are played at lunch on the outdoor basketball courts. Winning teams receive great prizes like Dodger tickets. Carry Underwood tickets. That's all for me. Now let's go to Connor Gilbertson in another segment in our bi-weekly series celebrating Black History Month.
To be detrimental to your safety to continue this march, and I'm saying that this is an unlawful assembly, you have to disperse. You are ordered to disperse, go home, or go to your church. This march will not continue.
Oh. John Lewis was born near Troy, Alabama, on February 21, 1940. He was the third oldest child of sharecroppers Willie Mae and Eddie Lewis. In 1968, he married Lillian Miles, with whom he would adopt one son, John Miles Lewis, in 1976. As a student, he organized sit-ins in Nashville's segregated lunch counters, organized bus boycotts, and participated in the Nashville student movement.
We were beaten by members of the Klan. They beat us. They left us lying in a pool of blood. The local police officials came up, wanted to know whether we wanted to press charges. We said no. We come with peace.
In 1961, he became one of the 13 original members of the Freedom Riders, a group of 7 black people and 6 white people that rode on segregated interstate buses from Washington, D.C. to New Orleans to challenge the policies of southern states within their route. The riders, including Lewis, suffered numerous verbal and physical attacks for their peaceful actions. After the Congress of Racial Equality canceled the program, he joined Diane Nash in organizing another attempt with Nashville students, an attempt that would be successful. On March 7th, 1965, he and Hosea Williams led over 600 marchers across the Edmund Pettus Bridge in Selma, a peaceful protest
not in any way be interfering with the pursuit of traffic
that would soon be met with brutal police violence. Lewis would bear scars from Selma the rest of his life. In 1986, he ran for the U.S. House of Representatives for Georgia's 5th Congressional District, a district he would represent until his death in 2020. Throughout his tenure, he became known for supporting expansion of voter rights and reform targeting wealth inequality. John Lewis was diagnosed with stage 4 pancreatic cancer in December 2019. He fought bravely for 8 months, finally passing away in Atlanta on July 17, 2020, at the age of 80. The day of his funeral, an op-ed penned by Lewis was released by the New York Times, in which he discussed the continued fight for political and economic equality. Even in his death, Lewis continued fighting for the rights and welfare of the oppressed, and his spirit will live on in the hearts of those who continue relentlessly fighting against oppression and inequality in America, in the hopes that there will never again be another Bloody Sunday.
D.C. and around the nation are sending a mighty, powerful, and strong message to the rest of the world that we would get them.
Thank you, Connor. Good morning, Saugus. I'm Jacob Mendez with the final segment of today's show. The Santa Clarita Emblem Club number 459 will be awarding 4 scholarships worth $800 to students enrolled in further education. 2 of the scholarships will be awarded to relative of a member of Elks Club number 2379 or Emblem Club number 459. The other 2 scholarships will be awarded to students in the community. You can pick up an application in the counseling office. Applications must be postmarked today. The application process for the PTSO scholarship is still open. To apply, you must be a senior with a GPA of 2.0 or higher, a current member of PTSO, submit a written essay, and applying to a college, vocational school, apprenticeship program, or the military. The application deadline has been extended to 3 p.m. on Thursday. The application and essay prompts have all been sent to qualifying students' emails. That's all for today. I'm Jacob Mendez. Stay tuned for SNN Radio and Saugus Today. Don't forget that tomorrow is a student help day for social studies, math, world language, industrial arts, and business. Have a great day, and we'll see you on Thursday.